ladies and gentlemen, my guests this week are going to be involved in what I think is going to be one of the great classic matchups as part of that star-studded card at WrestleMania 8. It's going to be for the Intercontinental Champion. First of all, introducing the challenger, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Former Intercontinental Champion. He wants it back. Real man. And has got the tools, as far as I'm concerned, Brain, to do just that.
The last thing he wants is to have a match of this importance and not beat a guy in a skirt.
It's called a kilt for your...
Look at that, a picture of Bret Hart, picture of Piper. Friends, question
right
mark.
Now,
I wonder.
From the champion.
Oh, I think they are.
Champion, Roddy.
They may have mutual respect for each other, but I don't think they care about friendship. He wants to hold on to that gold, and Bret Hart wants to take it. That simple. Business. Matter of business.
Everything is business to you. Dollars and cents.
Yep. Look, he's tearing his skirt now.
Dude, I'm going to tell him what you said.
Roddy Piper, Intercontinental Champion, you are not wearing your kilt this week.
I tell you, first of all, it's always nice to see the folks, and only time I wear my kilt is when I'm going to fight. Now, I'll tell you something. I didn't come here to talk about fighting today. Come here, sit down. Come here, sit down. Sit down, sit down.
Bret Hart, if you would, please.
Please, please. Bret, come here and sit down. Sit down. I didn't come here to talk about fighting. Actually, I come here to talk about something the whole world could use is not fighting. It's what I talked about, you know. Bret, I know you, doggone it, man. I know you since you've been about this high, man. I know you. Matter of fact, I might have changed diapers one time. I'm not positive, man. But I got to tell you, you know, in this fight, April 5th in WrestleMania, I'm going to back out. I'm not fighting there. I'm gonna give this one up. I'm not going to be in the Hoosier Dome. No. Don't give me no booze now back there. Let me explain something here. Let me explain something. You know, wait, please. I'll tell you something. You know, with Bret Hart here, I've known him for years. I know one time, I'll tell you one time, there was about 40 of us wrestlers, man. And we come to Bret Hart's house about 11 o'clock at night, and Bret Hart's mom, she come down in her bathrobe, man. She started making sandwiches faster than submarine could, man. And she fed us all, and she took care of us, and I sent her flowers, and she sent me a card, and I love your mom. I love your mom. And man, you know, if a guy could pick his mama, I'd pick your mama as a mom. I love her, and I can't find it in my heart to go out there and fight you. So I'm not gonna, man. I'm not gonna go to WrestleMania. I'm not gonna fight. I'm just gonna give the bye.
With all due respect, Roddy, you gotta understand, if you don't fight me, that means this belt's mine. That means the Intercontinental Championship's been forfeited. That means this is my belt.
Wait a minute. Hold it, folks. Do we have a new Intercontinental Champion before WrestleMania even starts?
Oh, everybody out of the pool. You shut up, and I don't think you understand what I'm saying to you. What I'm saying to you is you're a real nice man, and you come from a family of legends. And I know they're legends, and I know you fought your way, but I fought my way off the street, out of the gutter. I fight for keeps. Let me tell you to your face. If I'm going to fight you, if you think I'm going to go and shake hands with you April 5th in the Hoosier Dome and be real nice about it, you're full of baloney. If you're that serious about it and you want to fight, then you better shake hands now, because from now till April 6th, I'm going to hate your guts and I'm going to do everything I can to destroy you. It's your choice. You stick your hand out and shake mine. You gotta fight. If you don't, the nice thing would be, let's let it ride and let's have a nice friendship.
Somebody do something.
I guess I'll see you April 5th.
All right, champ. I'll see you April 5th.
All right, Edson Braddon, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa!
You know what, Bret? I would have had you, Bret. Come April the 5th, Hoosier Dome, I'm playing for keeps, Bret. See you later. But remember, I would have had you, Bret. I would have had you.
What a matchup. That's going to be at the Hoosier Dome, WrestleMania 8.